Hi there, my name is Randy Jenny and this is a short video to help you out with grader 2. So I'm going to start in cell C5 where I need to put in a lookup function. So I'm going to go paste function. I'm going to select VLOOKUP. You may have to do a search for it, but mine is right here. The lookup value I want to use is the SKU number. So I'm going to look up this number. I'm going to look it up in a table that I'm going to define down here, and I need to make the table absolute so that I anchor down the position of that table and it doesn't change if I copy this formula. Column index number is simply where I want to pull the result from out of the table. So if you think of this table as having three columns, column 1, 2, and 3, I want to pull out the description, so I'm going to use column 2. And I click done, and there's my refrigerator. And if I fill that down to row 13, it should work all the way down. If it doesn't work all the way down, chances are you missed the step about making this table definition absolute. I'm going to adjust the column width by double-clicking the right edge, and I'm good to go. There's one more example of VLOOKUP in this assignment, but if you understood the first one, you understand how to do the next one. So I'm going to skip over that one. I'm now in cell F5, and I'm going to use the IF function to figure out the total amount due. And the total amount is based on the price plus the delivery if they have selected delivery. So if it says yes, I want to add an additional $75 to the price. So I'm going to use an IF function to determine that. So if this cell D5 equals quote yes, then the price is going to be price E5 plus the delivery fee down here, the $75, and I need to make that one absolute. Otherwise, if it didn't say yes, it's simply the price. And click done, and I should be able to fill that down. And we want to format that as currency. And that's it for the if. The last part that's a little tricky is the payment function. So I'm in cell H5 and I'm going to insert payment, and payment needs to know the rate, so the rate is going to be the interest rate down here made absolute, but that's an annual interest rate and I want a monthly interest rate, so I have to go divided by the 12 down here and make that absolute. N per is the number of payments. So that's my 3 years times 12. Again, I need to make that absolute. And present value is the amount that I owe. So total due, which is F5. And I'm good to go. Now, the only problem is payments show up as negative numbers, so I need to put in a minus sign after the equal sign. And once I do that, it changes to a positive number. And if I fill that down, again, I'm good to go. And that's it. Thanks very much.